we are at Walyunga. And we're going to be paddling down to Amiens Road, down to Bell's Rapids, down to Terminator 2 Rapids, and then Bell's Rapids, and then finishing our paddle at Amiens Road. Okay, here we go. When it's that back person splashing the front person that'll get you during the day. Because that paddle stroke is just perfect just to, yeah, exactly, a little bit of that, yeah, yeah. But then of course the front person can always just accidentally, deliberately do one of these, you know, so. Have you guys? Have you guys seen moving water much? Okay. Give a yell if you need any advice or anything, but I'll try to take as little risk as possible. Called Eddie Pool. You'll notice as you come through that there's a couple of eddies that push you sideways. Every single time you get into this pool, it's just, you'll never go straight. For every one that shoots you one way, there's another to shoot you back again, so you just let it take you and you end up zigzagging. Yeah. Yeah, try and, when you've got corners coming up or turns coming up, try and practice cutting the corners as much as possible, but then not spinning out. Because obviously spinning out is, you know, bad. but try and take them as early as you can. The earlier you can start turning and anticipating and all that, the better. Usually you want the channel on the left-hand side of the dead tree here. Turn left as soon as you can, basically. Yeah, take that left-hand channel. Yeah, that's the one. And cut the corner at the bottom as much as you can. In low water, you want to take that channel down there. High water, right here. Thank you. Get it. Woof. Get out. Terminator 2 Rapids. One overhang, two overhang, both trees falling in the water. No more overhangs. Okay. Terminator 2, here we go. Thank you. Terminator 2. This is a little shortcut, either through there or through here. Stopping here. Okay, I think we'll wait at the top, yeah? Otherwise they might be halfway down, upside down, not knowing where each other are. Is it the same? Yeah. Is it just not tight enough still? Yes. you passed the first test, you stayed ahead of the singles. That's always, it's fun. You never want to get to rapids with someone in front of you, because then if they stuff up, you're stuffed, you know. Try and get a clear run in front. Always, you know, be very polite and say, may I overtake you before the rapids? Oh, you know. And then, as long as you're obviously okay with the line, you don't need to follow someone down. Then always try and have that clear run in front, yeah. Today, no, right now I follow, yeah, exactly. In the race though, isn't it? Yeah, most people do. Yeah. And then you got stuck on the rocks below and the water was pressing you on them, and yeah. So, yeah, I did the same at Bell's Main Shoot. That one time I've snapped a paddle while paddling has been bang, in a 5 mile in the front seat of that boat with my mate 15 years ago. Because you just, you know, you're so much, if you're trying to hold up both people and one paddle, well, doesn't have it, and you hit a rock or something. So the decision you make is if you. So with the singles and I guess with easy to turn boats, I always shoot across to the right and want to go straight down without turning and without doing stuff. So I suggest you try that. So we all come in from the left hand side of the main chute and then try and hit that rock on the left, stay as close to that rock on the left as you can coming in. But have your boat facing downstream. Don't have it turn, like, don't have it turning this way. That sucks, you know. Like, have it facing downstream. And then once you get down the drop, if you can start turning right, do it. Begin to turn right. Try and turn right and get down straight away without doing a U-turn. But if you can't, if the water goes whoa and you find yourself shooting left, then shoot left. Go left. Don't go straight. So basically, make a decision. And if you can go right, go right. That's the fastest way. That's where you want to be going. And it's a good way. But if the boat decides nah, and if the rock goes nah, and it's going this way, then shoot off to the left. These guys, and in that boat, I believe they will do the same thing. And in their longer Avon 3 they used to have, they always went left. Left was the way. Doing a huge a U-turn, and then heading out down the river again. A big corkscrew. You know, can't turn right, don't try, don't even bother. Just go left, and you'll be fine. You know? So do whatever you feel more comfortable with, but do it quickly. So basically, get the boat side on. And if you can't get it that way side on, get it the other way side on. You know, just get it turning. So if you start turning, I mean, I guess it'll be like yell it to yourselves. Like, maybe try and turn right no matter what, and then see how hard that was, and then decide whether, we could have gone left there. Because you might think, oh, no, we can't go left. Left was going to be worse. You know, left we were going to go, smash into the rocks. But just start turning, and then power through. And then you've got that second wave after the main chute, which is no worries. But by the time you hit that second wave and get through it, then you have to start lining up for the Devil's Slide below it. And we've got the middle of Devil's Slide is the right way to go. So we'll all go down there together. We'll go down the correct way. And you'll see that, don't worry about, almost point the boat where you need it to go. Yeah, it'll start doing this and the water will push it this way and that way. Don't worry about it. The water will push you into the correct location. Just once you line it up, power, and then get your brace strokes ready. Then have your strokes and there'll be rocks, so learn how to brace on rocks and then like, oh, there's a hole below the rock, how do I brace there? Okay, well, don't hit the air, you know, hit the rock and then the water below it, so be ready. So you'll see, you know, that your Devil's Slide is the one with the rock, and then there's like little channels in between the rocks. And just keep your paddle ready to brace and keep the boat upright, like don't tilt it at all. They say, you know, lean the boat, nah, bugger, don't lean the boat, you know. And then directly after Devil's Slide, you've got that S-bend part, they call it side swipe. And today it's high enough to not do that, to go the cheating chute on the left, correct, yeah. So jag left as soon as you go through Devil's Slide. You might turn over, oh my god, shit, but then no, left after that. And then, yeah, you especially, you're going to be slowing down in the front. Do, you know, get it sideways on, because the water pressure there is not flowing very quickly. So get it side on and then power out of there. So and then dog's breakfast underneath is just today it'll be fine. You go straight ahead down the middle and yeah, lots of rocks and low water. That's right. Yeah. In low water, there's those rocks below the dog's breakfast. Totally. Yeah. You can almost like backpedal and just like go go down and walk in the street. This main chute, and I used to come here with like a million miles an hour, and then hit rocks and boom, you know, kind of thing. Yeah, totally, totally. Okay, you guys want to lead? Alrighty, I think. Do you want to stop? Do you want to stop below Sidewinder before Devil, before Dog's Breakfast? Okay. And you're welcome to go in front of me, or you're welcome to go behind? Follow? Okay. Yep. I'll spin around a fair bit to have a look, see how you guys are doing. And yeah, we'll stop after Sidewinder, after Devil Slide, after Sidewinder. Yeah, before Dog's Breakfast. Okay, we're okay. These guys have come out and their boat is stuck in the river. So we might hang here for a second and just see whether they haven't blocked our chute. So we can go down. They're stuck in Devil's Slide there. Their boat is blocking the river. So we'll give it a few minutes and just decide whether here is a good spot to wait or down further is a good spot to wait. So I think we might be looking for paddles and things because, this is just a nice pool, you know. Don't want to wait where there's somewhere that we're going to turn over. You guys did that perfect, hey?
Yeah, that was awesome.
Oh, too much to the left. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, yeah. Well, did you guys approach it from that same direction? So what Dad and my brother did wrong was they came in like you did, but they were facing that way and they went right across the river and they weren't facing downstream. And you guys turned around that corner and then powered down. Perfect. But they thought, oh. Exactly. Get the line, get the line, and then power, power, power. You had all the time in the world to turn and you got it perfect. You turned in the correct direction. I better go down and help them. So there, maybe you can do Devil's Slide behind me and then turn around where I turn around as well. So we'll get into this eddy over here again and then re-line up again. Just fairy glide across this one. Don't get sucked into those rocks down the bottom. Good to go. Okay. Remember to keep your paddle in the water. Can you stop here? Go straight through if you need to. I think you'll be right. Yeah. Yeah, it all slows down here. I think that they've got their paddles, and I'm just not sure if any more people will help. You know, if they can't do it, then we can't do it, sort of thing. But I was wondering. My brother's strong. My brother's pretty strong, but my dad's getting on. That's so. Yeah. I'll see. I'll give them a yell and see if they look like they're moving it. We got a dad in the water. Got a boat coming down. Yeah, it's dislodged, but they don't have it. It's gonna get stuck in the next one. Get to the bank! What are you doing? Thank you. actually, if you do just want to, well, I don't want you guys to have to get wet. We'll be okay. They'll be swimming over here in a moment. So while the guys are in the water, actually, I'll just try and get this out of the water. There's a little tab on the bottom side there. Yeah, that should be fine there, actually. Yeah, that should be fine. Thanks a lot. I just they fell over just up here, and I'm just. Yeah, oh, they're over there. They're in the water. They swam. Yeah. That's right. They washed it. Yeah. It's my dad. My dad and my brother. They're just, they're on the island in the middle, so I think they're going to have to swim over here. They'll get it. They'll be here soon. But maybe if you could just pull it a little bit higher, or just make sure it doesn't float away, but I think it's quite fine there. It's very heavy because it's full of water, so I don't think it'll float away now. I think you're very good there. Yeah, perfect. Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, right way up. Yeah, perfect. Alrighty. Okay. And there's a bridge that they need to walk across to get here. Are they coming? I think. Did they lose a paddle? Yeah, I thought they had. So I've done that with my little 415 single version of this on that exact same rock, and I had to hop in the water 3 times, wash myself down, grab the boat, slid off it twice. Third time I got it, so I'm glad Dad got it the first time there. I think we'll all hang out here, mate. Thanks a lot, eh? That's fine, yeah. Thanks, eh? Cheers, that's plenty, yeah. Oh, thanks. Getting your workout today. That's plenty, yeah, thanks. We'll probably all jump out here and, yeah, thanks a lot. Did your rescue for the day. Yeah, that's right. Yeah. Most of the time you can just bump it, just pop it straight out again. But sometimes you need the hot gun, heat gun or the hairdryer. And but that's the worst this boat's ever had. And you know, often like you'll get your nose stuck in between two rocks and then you'll go around and then the nose will stay where it is and oh my god, you know. Yeah, it doesn't seem to be as. They say that they're indestructible, and I've seen people that have like put a boat 90 degrees around a log or something and then popped it out. Sometimes there's a little mark, but often there's not. There's just a little ripple and you know, you wouldn't even know it. Oh, that's a bugger. Yeah, so they came into the main chute facing side on, and then immediately, I mean, I could see it a mile away because they came around that corner and then they didn't turn. They just kept on going across. Yeah, and then the water got it and whoop, and you can, no, like you're saying, I did the exact same thing. Breaststroke, came around the corner, breaststroke on the right in the front seat, and the whole power of that water is, you know, you're upstream, you're leaning upstream now, and it's impossible to lean downstream while you're in the rapids, so don't put yourself in that position. And yeah, they had no chance, but that's because Dad never does bells properly. He always comes in at a huge angle in a single, and then turns the boat at the last minute and ends up facing a completely different direction. And I'm like, you can't do that in a double, man. You shouldn't be turning at all. That's why I, above the rapids, I turned, line up, okay, go. You know, and you got time, you got plenty of time. Everyone thinks, oh, you've got 3 seconds, like the approach wave at Bell's there. I often spin out. In this thing, you often spin out and go backwards. And oh, well, sorry guys, I'll muck around here for a bit. But that's also because you've got time to set yourself up. And you don't need to, the water pressure isn't going to rush you down the rapids. Oh my God, so many people turn over on that approach wave and then wash down the main chute. Yeah. And you're like, guys, you had 10 seconds between those two to work out what you needed to do. And you turned over and you still didn't have time. You know, like, my God, you had plenty, you had all day. So yeah, the time thing is a big factor, I reckon. I think they might be a little while. Yep. Oh yeah, cool. We might empty their boat for them, how about that? If I can lift the damn thing.
So this just like knocks out?
Yeah, well I mean that one will be easy, that would, yeah. Yep. But But then even if it was like a big one, you could just, you know, wrench it around on something. Now, best way, we'll just tip it to begin with and just let it pour out the side. Whoop, there's a nice little stick there. Airbags in the back here, so I don't know if they actually... Well, yeah, exactly. I don't know if they help or hinder. Half and half. Oh, okay. Well, I think there's a little bit... Yeah, we'll do one more. Just let it come down this way. And then, so let it all the way down and then get it back up again. Yeah, there we go. Lucky they got a V in the middle, so at least the water pours out, whereas some boats don't have a V there.
So just have like gunnels down the right.
And
right
it pours from the front to the back. Great one. That probably should be
about right.
Okay. Yeah, I'd say that's okay. Yeah. Oh man, my stick has barely survived like one day, I know. I need glue or something on them. The top half of the boat's all this like material that lets water bead off it. It's rough, so there's like glossy area where you can put stickers, and then rough area where nothing fits. So so this part of the sticker comes off, and the bottom half stays on. It's no one designed it for big stickers, obviously. So, but good fun. Jeez, you guys came through all right, and I like the turn below Devil Slide up there. That was good. Below Devil's Slide, yeah, where you came through and then you hard left. I thought, oh, that's going to be a bit tough for you guys, but you didn't have a problem cutting left just here and eddying out.
Yeah, I don't think we took the right...
to get into the
cheat
line. No, you did. Devil's Slide, that one right of middle. So the guys were stuck on the far left. Yeah, slightly too far right. Yeah, but you're in the correct gap between two rocks.
Yeah,
like, the two rocks are that chute has, what is it, one's upstream of the other. So you come down it, and then you jag over to the left as you're in the chute. And it like, so you're coming down and you're like, oh, I should have been over to the left more. But no, the left was, like, there were rocks above you, but it's slightly sideways. Yeah, and it jags you over this way. So you've got to have that left-hand brace stroke ready. Totally.
Over the side.
That's right, It's not straight. It's all the way around the thing to the side.
You can just like, yeah.
But at 1.5 meters, this wave is worse than the Bell's main chute wave, and this wave turns you over. So you've got to miss this wave. There's like a big hole that's like that deep.
Thanks, guys.
Hey. Popped out the little bump, so I think there's no damage either.
No.
Geez, you didn't line up for the main chute. You came into the main chute sideways. Yeah, but you were facing like this, not like that. So the last minute, you and the 4 and 5 always turn about 90 degrees, and you tried to do that in this boat, and it doesn't hook, it doesn't turn. And you must never turn down a chute. Well, I mean, you were like this, you know, like you were facing this way to the bridge, and these guys came in and they just backpedaled a few more times than you before the main chute, and they went left. They didn't take the right hand. So you guys were angled ready to take that right hand channel after the main chute, but you should be worried about the main chute first. Yeah, I think here the water's pretty much all out. A tiny bit of water in the here we go, it's just a bad angle for it, so gave it a few upside down knees, but never got it all out. launch right here and back out. Yeah, yeah, we approach it from the most left you can be, that right on the, that little channel through there, yeah, yeah. But that's mainly in low water just to get you lined up for the bit that's possible, so today you can pretty much go anywhere. But I'll line you up, yeah, that most left-hand channel that you can see there, where that dead tree pokes outwards, you want to go through that channel, in fast-moving water. Yeah. In low water, that's the obvious, that's the only way to go, so that would be where you remember. You guys getting out of here? Okay, yep. You got everything? Yep, yep, cool, cool. Stay near the bank, there's less rocks, yeah. Good way to put a hole in your boat. Yeah. Sorry? Oh, was it today?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, okay, because... you saw carrying the boat might have been it. I saw a downriver boat that was on the guy's shoulder. A couple in. Because they're only allowed on the water after midday. But they were, that's right. Yeah. It's Chris with a K. Chris, I forget his last name. Chris Smith. He organises it all. He's got a blue one of these. Yeah, he used to do those. I did one of them. It was one the weekend after the race. And you're like, you come down here and you're just buggered, and everyone else is, you know, in it to win it sort of thing. Yeah, DR boat, yeah. Decent. Yeah, that would have been fun, jeez. So did you, I didn't even see. Did you guys came down the cheating rapid on the side here? Did you?
Yeah.
Oh, you would have made it through. No worries, because you can cut all the corners. Like you could just bump over. You didn't even need to make the turn there today. Well, it is easier all the time, but that only flows in about 0.4. So if it's 0.3, you've got to come here, and it sucks. You know. Sort of that's the case, that once the easy stuff flows, well, the hard stuff's easy then anyway, so you don't need the hard, you don't need that chicken. The chicken chute's pointless because it's only open when you don't need it. Oh well, gave the people on the bridge something to watch. Me? Okay. I can lead us down. Yeah, I'll lead these guys, but alrighty. That's okay. I'm just going to take straight ahead, straight through the middle. It'll all be open today. So we'll go all the way to the bottom, Bolland's elbow. All the way down. Alrighty. Yeah. I think we've got a log in the channel here, so just be careful at the top here. Yeah, boy! Nice one! Easy from here. You're all good. Nah, that's all good. I go backwards in this bit. Hey, Izzy! How you going? Hey, how you going, guys? Ew. Sailing from here. They got their white water carnival on right now. Races. Hey Chris. Yo. How you going? Good, man. Yeah. Yeah, it's pretty good. These guys did competency. I have fun down here. I should have mentioned that I go backwards a little bit too much. Hey, hello. That's right. Just like that log that I actually just sideswiped going backwards there that I didn't see. I meant to do that. Hey, how you going? Right side. Follow Dad. Follow them. Yeah, they're taking the easy way. Hello. I know. I thought it was that way. Cheers, guys. Thank you. Alrighty. Yeah, at the bottom of dog's breakfast there, my boat just goes the opposite direction by itself, and it's easier for me to spin backwards and then take that next section backwards than it is to try and make that turn. It's just hilarious the way that the water acts on the boat. Hello! Yeah, sorry to stuff you up and go that way. One way only. Yeah, little tiny gap. Yep. And this big flat rock in the middle here that's usually out of the water as well. Yeah. It's just nothing. Yeah, it's just no. I'll still try and hit the trees. G'day. How you going? How's it going? A bit of an eddy. And back again. Yep. Around there? Yeah. Yeah. Little tiny gap. There's one of those above, after Walyunga, there's as you came around that little S bend, just after Walyunga. There's a shortcut through the tea trees which like cuts the corner, and we used to call that the pro channel because only the pros used to take it, and it would save like 2 meters, and it was really dangerous and really hard to get into, and you could easily turn over and get caught in something, but whoa, you saved 2 meters. Yeah. So like I always look at that thinking, yeah, ugh. And I took it today. It was okay because it was all open and high, but you know, I gained 2 meters. Hooray. Oh yeah, that's it, man. Yeah, I feel more confident now. You know, little badge on my uniform. Yeah, if you can hook onto a wave of your same boat type, you'll be getting about 10%, well, maybe up to 10% of a tow. So a lot of the time, you want to try and get on the boat waves of other guys, like the boat in front, for example. I'm not fast enough to keep on your wave, but if I was, then you'd be giving me a huge turbo boost. Yeah. alternate route. I think that's the way. Enough water to go everywhere today. That's a new way. Don't usually go here. Yeah, I know. You've been faster than me. Thank you. know, you can cut out an entire paddock of the river. You go down there when it's very high. That's an actual shortcut. It cuts out a whole sheep paddock. And there's a little bridge over the creek there that the farmer built. And never expected paddlers to be paddling under it, and I'm sure. One of them washed away and the other one was still there since the flood. 2017. Twice in my life. Oh, once in my lifetime, yeah. But that's been open. And then it's been high. Yeah. Farmer's fields, like you're on the wrong side of a fence. You know, like you're inside a farmer's field and you got to hop over a fence to get back into the main river. We did that once. There's a big gouge on the bottom of that blue boat where we went over the top of a fence. Because we went over it when it was high and then had to get back to the river somehow, but the fence was now, you know, out of the water. Uh-oh. What do you reckon? Thank you. Righty. Neville's Channel on the right. Amazon Passage for us. Haha. This obstacle, not an obstacle anymore. Ow. Crunch much. That one is actually loose. Ha. Amiens Crescent. Hey. Success.